Hey, this is Peter from NextEnt. In the latest version of Smart Slider Pro, we released the Instagram Generator, which can be used to create sliders from images and videos from your Instagram feed. Let's take a look at how to build a slider. First, you need to create an app at Facebook using the link you can find in the description. If your Facebook account isn't registered as a developer account yet, you need to go through the registration process. Once it is done, you can start creating applications. Press the Create App button. Here you should choose Consumer and press Next. Give a name to your application at display name. And press Create App. Re-enter your password and submit the form. Press Setup at Instagram Basic Display. As the notification says, you have to set up some Meta application settings before you can proceed to the Instagram application. Go to the basic settings of the app. Enter a privacy policy URL and a data deletion instructions URL. Meta requires these URLs as this application can be used with the data of other users too, who would need to know how their data will be used and how they can ask for this data to be deleted. As you will only access your own data, you can stay in development mode, which means no one will check these URLs. So the content of the URLs won't matter. The only requirement is that these URLs have to be live. Scroll to the bottom of the page and press Add Platform. Choose Website and press Next. This will create a new field where you have to enter the URL of your website. Press Save Changes. In the left menu, go to Instagram Basic Display. Press the down arrow and click on Basic Display. Now the notification you've seen earlier is gone, and we can create the Instagram app. Press Create App. Scroll to the bottom of the page and press Add or Remove Instagram Testers. Here you can add Instagram testers to your application. Just enter the username of your Instagram user and click on the found result. Press Submit and go to Instagram using the link you can find in this video's description. Go to Tester Invites. Finally, accept the invitation of your application. Go to the dashboard of Smart Slider. Enter the global settings using the setting item on the top menu. Click on Generators. And choose Instagram. You need to paste the details of your app here. First, copy the callback URL. And go back to the app configuration page. Once again, enter Instagram Basic Display, Basic Display. Scroll lower on the page to the URL fields. Paste the copied URL into the valid OAuth3 Direct URLs field. Only this URL is used by Smart Slider, but Meta requires the deauthorize callback URL and the data deletion request URL fields to be filled as well. You can just simply paste the same URL into these fields and press Save Changes. Now copy the Instagram app ID and the Instagram app secret. Press Show to see the secret. Go back to Smart Slider and paste them into the app ID and secret fields. Once you are done, press Request Token. In the pop-up window, press Allow to give access to your account. Now your application is done and ready to be used. Go back to the dashboard. Press New Project to start creating your slider. It should be a new project. Change the height to 700 pixels and press Create. To create our example's design, first I will start with the slider settings. Go to the Controls tab and turn off the arrows. Then turn on the bullets. The design of the fourth one is close to what I'm looking for. Let's change the position to outer bottom. Use minus 14 pixels as the offset. This will make the bullets appear partially on the slider. Enter the dot style settings. change the color of the border, then switch to active state. Set the same color for the background. Finally, apply the style settings. Enter the style settings of the bar. The background can be less transparent. Apply the changes. This was the last setting I wanted to change, so save the slider. Let's add the new slide. Choose to add dynamic slides. Select Instagram. Here you can see the dynamic slide settings. First, you should decide what content you would like to display. Single images, albums, or maybe videos. I will just display my single images. Here you can set how the date and time looks. You can use any PHP date format, add the date format and time format option. I've placed the link about these in the description of the video if you want to learn more about them. I would like to display the month name, day, and year with this format. Then you can set the order of the received data. The descending creation date would show your latest Instagram posts. Lower, you can find the generator settings, like how often you would like to check for new Instagram posts. I want to have 3 slides. Now press View Records to see what data will be available on the slides with the current settings. Each line represents 1 slide. As you see, the date variable displays the date in the set format. Close this window. And on the top right, press Add to create your dynamic slides. You'll see a default layout first, but don't worry, you can completely change it. I want to create a totally different design, so let's start by removing the background image and setting a color instead. It should be this powder color. Now put down a 2-column row and insert an image layer to the right side. At each field, like in this case at the image field, you can find the data button. Pressing this will bring up the variable selector. Select the image variable to display the Instagram image. Now remove the paddings from the column to make the image bigger. The row has some unnecessary paddings too, which should be removed. Then change the gutter value of the row, so that there is no space between the columns. Put down another 2-column row into the left column. And insert a heading layer into the left one. Open up the variable selector at its text field. And select the username variable. You can write anything next to the variables. I want an at sign before the name. The text you write stays, but the variable will be replaced. Go to the Style tab. Modify the font family to Inter. Then change the color and the font size. The font weight should be bold and the line height smaller. Insert a heading to the other column. Enter the data variables. And select the date variable. Insert it. Now go to its style tab. Modify the color and the font weight settings. Select the headings column and remove its paddings. Do the same with the left column. Lastly, remove the paddings of the row 2. Go to the Content tab. Turn up the Full Width option, which will make the row as wide as the content inside. Change the gutter to 5 pixels. And select the Big Left column. With its inner align, we can set the alignment of all layers inside it. Insert the heading layer also to the left. Enter the variable selector at its text. This layer should display the caption of the Instagram posts. Go to the style settings. Change the color, the font size, and the font weight. then scroll lower. Separate the margin values and add the values you see. Because of the negative margin, the text will overlap the image. But you need to adjust the Z-index of the left column to make sure that it is above the right column. Add another row under the latest text. And insert a heading layer into the left column. Change the text to Next Post. Then go to the Style tab. Modify the color to white. And the font size to 16 pixels. Insert an image layer to the right column and open the media library. Here I will select an arrow image. Select the left column and remove its paddings. Now select the row and turn off its full width settings. Use 0 pixel as the gutter value. Then press the plus sign at the link. Go to the Action tab. Open the action and select Next Slide. This will make the slider switch to the next slide when a user clicks on the row. Go to the Style settings. And add the background color, then a border radius. Lower, we should separate the paddings to add different values for different sides. Open the Add panel. Turn on absolute positioning and add an image layer. Double-click on it to select a different image. This will be a decorative element. That is why absolute positioning is used. Open the layer list. And move the image into the left bigger column. This way we can position the image to the column. Select the image. Go to its Style tab and scroll lower to the position settings. Use right alignment to position to the right side of the column. Now, if I change the position values to 0 pixels, the image will be perfectly positioned to the center right part of the column. The desktop layout is done, and we can move on to the layer animations. Select top fade animation for this layer. Change the duration value to 600 milliseconds. Add the delay 200 milliseconds. The Y offset should be smaller. Click on the other image layer and let's set up an animation for this one too. Change the Y offset value and press the play button on the bottom left to check out both animations together. They look the way I wanted them, so we can move on to the responsive setup. At the top device selector, click on Tablet View. The biggest problem here is the font size. Use the font resizers to make it smaller. Then decrease the right margin of this text. The tablet view is done, so move on to the mobile view. Let's move the layer window closer to the side. And open the layer list. Select the main row and go to its Content tab. Switch up the columns to have the image on top. Then increase the gutter to create some space between the columns. Select the lower column. And change the inner align to center. Use the font resizers to make the text smaller. Go to the Style tab settings. Remove the negative right margin value as we want the text to fit into the slide. Resize the text from the row. It should be just a little smaller. Then modify the paddings of the row. Increase the top and bottom padding of the slide element. The slide is done, so we can save it. Let's take a look at the preview to see the generated slides. All slides will have the same design as what you set up for the first one. The responsive view should be fine as well. Check the tablet and mobile views. Everything seems fine, but there is one more trick I would like to show you. Go to the generator settings. You can see that this dynamic slide creates three slides with start index 1. You don't necessarily have to start from the very first data you're generating creates. You can start from the second, third, and so on data as well. Just change the start index to the number you want to start from. Let's set the slide number to 1 to only create one slide. Press save. And go back to the slider settings page. Open the slide menu to duplicate your slide. Then enter the generator settings of the new dynamic slide. Replace the start index value with 2 to make your slide show the second Instagram post. Save on the settings. And enter the slide editor. Now you can modify anything on the slide, such as the background color of it. This way, your first slide will have a different color than the second. And you can go through this process again to have more slides. So the start index can be used to create different designs for the different slides. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please leave a like, and if you would like to see similar videos in the future, subscribe. Have a great day!